So we know that genomic DNA is made up by a double helix with two filaments. In the recent years, we have discovered that some portion of the genomic DNA contains two genes at the same time. In one filament, there is a protein coding gene. On the other filament, in the opposite direction, there is a gene that is transcribing non-coding RNA, so an RNA that will never be translated in a protein. So these non-coding RNA in the other filaments are called antisense. We have discovered that this antisense RNA is actually able to increase protein synthesis of a sense gene. And this is important since until now all the non-coding RNAs involved in this process have been considered inhibitory. We have shown that this non-coding RNA has two structures, two modules. One is involved in increasing protein synthesis, the other one is involved in giving specificity because it is antisense to a certain gene. By substituting this specific antisense part to an antisense part to any gene of interest, we are indeed able to increase protein synthesis of the gene that we want. This is important because it can be applied both at the industrial level in order to increase industrial protein production, or at therapeutics level in order to act in vivo in patients to increase protein synthesis of the gene involved in disease.